So this is day two of our £1,500 challenge. What we've done, we're just down the road from Hornsey on the east coast, and we've come to a lovely little motocross track. We've got Simon Pavey, BMW rider, Dakar expert, and he's going to take each bike around this track. It's nearly a mile long. He's going to set the pace on each bike, and then we're going to have a go. And we are by no means experts off-road riders, and if we can get it round, we're going to see how close we can get to the expert's time.
Right, here we are, ready for the timed laps. This is Simon Pavey, our expert of the day. He's going to take each bike for a flying lap, and we're going to time it. And afterwards, we've got to see if we can match it, better it, make him look stupid. We'll try. First up is the Africa Twin.
And the big question is the clutch going to make one more lap?
No, hopefully not.
Don't need the clutch.
On a drop of the hand, 3, 2, 1, go! So he's only had one lap on each bike as a warm-up measure, and now he's got to guess it. May God be with him. Oh, there's a bit of bash guard action there. Decking out on the hard stuff. And Simon Pavey reckons this bike is the best one of the lot. Knows how. It's a shed to me. But he is getting some air out of the damn thing. We might have to repair the surface afterward. And there he is. And that was a lap on the Africa Twin. What was the time, Phil?
2:01 dead.
Oh. You've just seen Phil West Africa Twin get hammered around here in 2:01. Now's the time for Adam Child, Super Tenere Yamaha. As you've probably noticed, the eagle-eyed of you will have spotted, we've made a subtle modification here. We've lost the rear subframe rack type thing and the top box. It wasn't deliberate. Poor old Simon here is responsible. He was doing his warm-up lap and it fell off bit by bit, which is quite comical, really. But anyway, he's ready to go on this one and we'll see what happens. 3, 2, 1! Simon Pavey didn't like the top box on the bike, and we think it was a deliberate movement to get rid of it. No, we think he's slower on this one. There's something holding him back.
2:01, 2:02, 2:03, 2:04, 2:05.
Okay, and that was a Super Tenere. And what time was it, Phil?
2:06.
There you have it, 5 seconds slower than the Africa Twin. Okay, next on the Oki is the DR Big. Mine. 3, 2, 1!
Get on with it, you p***.
I think we can see from here, from our vantage point, that this bike is easier to flick in the turns. It feels lighter underneath. He did actually say to me earlier on his warm-up lap that the front forks are the big problem with this bike. In fact, that they're so soft that they're bottoming out over the jumps, causing the bash plate to ground out and everything, and the front end tucks as well. But he'll give it all he can. Okay, that was a DR Big, and the time was, Phil?
2:05.
Oh, bollocks.
The main thing that's holding you back on this at the moment is obviously the suspension's a little bit scary on the jumps. And the fact that it's just got bent handlebars, because when you're hitting the bumps, you're, and a few of the corners I overshot on this, because since the front wheel's light, you know, your hands naturally go to a straight position, and the wheel comes down, and you're shooting off the track a little bit. So I think, you know, with a good set of bars on this and just a little bit of setup, you'd definitely get a couple of seconds back.
There's all my excuses gone.
So now it's our turn to see what we can do to match Simon. First up, Adam Child on his Super 10. How's it feeling, Chad?
I'm scared and I got muscle pump already.
All the best, mate. Oops, Mr. Gear there. Do you think he'll make it round? Not quite sure. Do we think his bike will make it round? Even less likely. I don't think Simon's time's in too much trouble at this stage. Then again, who might talk? I'm going to be rubbish. What's he going to make of this? Way! Oop, bit of air. Way, foot down. There's a jump. Oh, bit of air there, Chad. Way, over this big jump. Whoa! Okay, first we had Adam Child on his Super 10 race, posted a time of 2 minutes 22. Now it's turn for Trevor Franklin on his trusty DR. He's a competitive soul, is Trevor. Let's see what he can do. How do you think you're going to do, Trevor?
I'm not sure. At the moment, I'm shaking like a shitting dog, so I'm a bit nervous, I'll be honest with you.
But best luck, mate.
I'll give it what I can.
Okay, best luck, mate. Off we go. And he's away, Trevor Franklin. Go on, Trevor. Oh dear. Trevor's bike's leaking apparently. Let's see if he makes it around. It's okay, we've got a van, Simon. He's revving it hard. Whoop, back end steps out a bit. Come on, Trevor. Will his old body stand up to it? Whoop. He goes to the inside line around there. Up over another jump. Whoa, back end follows him down. Up to 2 minutes 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, whoa! Trev, you haven't finished yet, mate! You haven't finished! Come on, you gotta pick it up. You see? Come on, Trevor, you can do it. Come on.
That's outside assistance. That'd be
Come on, you gotta beat Paul's
time. Just push it. Yeah.
Come on, this way. I'll beat you, Trev.
Push someone.
Yeah, go on.
Don't go off the edge. There. 2 minutes, 45 seconds to Mr. Franklin.
Dude, that's gotta hurt. You're right.
Yeah.
That's a French fire. Wow, that
was a
Trev, bad crash.
Won, mate.
I didn't win.
Well, as you can see, despite the crash, I'm in one piece, and I'm here to introduce young Phil West and his Africa twin, who's out to beat the time of young Adam Child. To be fair to Phil, he has a slight injury. He's got a bruise on his crack of his ass the size of my boot. We're not going to go into the reason why. But anyway, are you ready for this, Phil?
Just about, if I have to. I'm cacking myself.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, mate, good
luck. Your hand hurts too.
Good luck to you. Yeah. Anyway, this is Phil West on his Africa twin. God help him. On your marks, get set, go! For those of you who want to know, the reason Phil's got a bruise on his arse is because he just come back from a Dainese product launch in Italy, where the Dainese had a ride out with the stars like Max Biaggi, Luca Nelli, and a couple of other old timers, where everybody had a lovely time, and Phil decided to pull an impromptu wheelie on a Marini scrambler, I think it was, hooked up in a second, and next thing you know, he was on his bum. Ego damaged, bum damaged, thumb damaged. Poor old Phil, never mind. I'll teach
you. Beat a 2:40, what was it, Trev? 2:45?
Yeah, there's truth in that. He could beat my time.
It helps if you don't have to push it up the line.
Well, yeah. Here he comes on the home straight. Looking very professional. And there he is, he's across the line. What do you reckon the time was in, Phil?
Yeah, worse than Chad Benyu. So, 2:26, 2:30.
The time actually was, Simon?
2:20.
2:20. There we have it. And what did young Adam Child record?
2:22.
There we have it then. I think we can put that down to the Africa twin winning, rather than the rider. But anyway, a good day out.
Yeah.
Showing better damage. And the bike is intact, believe it or not.
More than anything. Just proving you have great fun with 1,500 quid bikes.
That's it.
I got that.
Yeah, so did I.